Did you see the cute boy in class? Where'd you buy those jeans?
Welcome to Formspring.me, the newest social media site hot among teens, answering the questions that inquiring minds want to know.
Who is your first kiss?
How many siblings do you have?
Just sign up for an account, search for people to follow, and ask them any question you want, with complete anonymity if you choose.
And someone else wrote, who's your best friend?
If you haven't heard of it, you're not alone. The site launched just 6 months ago, but chances are your kids are some of the reported 50 million visitors to Formspring each month.
What college do you want to go to?
These girls love it, they say, because it's a great new way to connect with friends or learn more about them.
It's also kind of fun looking on my friends' pages to see what questions they've answered.
Want more followers? Simply link Formspring to your Twitter and Facebook accounts and invite all of your online pals to ask you a question.
If you can't talk to somebody on the phone or you're not with them, then you can ask questions and get an answer.
Seems innocent enough, but a growing number of parents fear Formspring is turning into cyberbully heaven, with threats of violence, questions about sex, and statements filled with hatred all too common.
I hate you.
Why are you so ugly?
Some of the bullying, it hurts the moms more than it hurts some of the kids. You know, it's just so painful to watch a child go through that.
I decided to follow a handful of teens from across the state to see what they were asking. And look what I found. Some posts too graphic to say out loud. I want to kill you so badly, commented one teen. Another, you look like a horse. I hate you. Best-selling author of Odd Girl Out and Curse the Good Girl, Rachel Simmons, says a site can be dangerous. By signing up, she says, you are inviting others to bash you with their honest opinions, often breathtaking cruelty, or cyber bombs, as she calls them, that can launch the intended target into a frenzy, wondering who could have written it.
Teenagers want to know what other people think of them, and girls especially are always second-guessing each other. Oh, did she really mean it as a joke when she said that my shirt was too tight? Formspring gives kids an opportunity to get the answer to the question, what are people really thinking about me? The problem is, kids are saying things they would never actually say, and it's impossible to know if it's really felt or if it's just obnoxious remarks.
While some girls can brush it off,
someone said, why do you think you're so cool when you're really not? And it can be hurtful if you take it to heart. So I didn't take it too personally.
For others, these kinds of cyber taunts can lead to depression and, worst case scenario, suicide. Consider the recent headlines. Some suspect vicious taunts on Formspring contributed to the suicide of this Long Island high school senior in March, although her parents deny postings on the site had anything to do with it. Formspring does acknowledge that cyberbullying exists on its website, and they make it very clear right here on their community guidelines page that they will work with police to track down abusive accounts. They also say if you post objectionable material, they will shut your account down. But experts say don't wait for the company to shut your kids' accounts down. It may be too late. Simmons says parents need to be aware of what their kids are up to online. Just type in your child's name to see if they have an account.
If you are a kid who is fundamentally insecure, who has low self-esteem, who has very sad or destructive beliefs about herself, then logging onto Formspring becomes a way to confirm that. And a kid who sees that day in and day out is going to be broken down inside. And that's why every parent needs to talk to their child about this site or go on the website.
So while Formspring may start out as a silly, innocent online game for some...
Ew, okay, that's just weird.
It's anything but silly for the person being written about. Sarah Underwood, Fox 25 News.